have to apologize, Mr. Stričko, who is teacher there, but he cannot come here, and he kindly asked me to present his presentation. I just start with myself. My name is. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Recognize, by the way, this carton was painted by parent of the chess players. We just as a chess player, we meet a lot of people from different areas, and paint this sketch is not only for me, but for many chess players. So my name is Stanislav Vlček, I am from Bratislava, and I am still currently manager of project chess in schools. And I have also other chess functions, which are not topic of this presentation. I work in Bratislava Chess Union as a trainer, as an organizer, usually on a youth tournament, but also others. But let's shift to Velka Ida. So this school, this primary school of Velka Ida, is partner of Erasmus, and teacher there is Mr. Vladimir Stričko. This is how school looks like. Velka Ida is small village. It's in the border between Slovakia and Hungary, not so far to Ukraine, and it is a region where a lot of socially poor.
Socially disadvantaged, socially poor children.
Yes, like this. Let's say that it's from Roma community, and even is in this school, the ratio is like 50% of Roma children and 50 not Roma. So children from this community, they are very gifted to play like instruments, to sing, to make some arts, but they are not very good in technical or humanitarian subjects. It's well known, and it's surprised that they decided to take our subject as a chess, and they want to have this subject mathematical didactical games. They use our materials from chess in schools, which federation gives to every school 12 of chess boards and chess sets, and started from first year. This is Mr. Stričko with his first grade pupils. This is right about that class is mixed. There are Roma pupils and also non-Roma. And they start
gypsy people, but it's like it's very to say like gypsies. So
probably you will know this word better, but we are forbidden to say it. So they started in year 2015. And started in four classes in the first year. It's when school decide to introduce chess. It is not It's for three years. We have a law about this, that when you introduce such a subject, you have to continue for at least 3 years. So till the third grade, you have to have chess. So it's quite a harsh condition. Apart from they are from the Roma community, because they are close to Hungary, many of them even doesn't speak Slovak very well. They speak, their native speech is Hungarian, or even Gypsy.
Gypsy language. Gypsy
is good? Gypsy language, okay. They have Gypsy language, and I think also Hungarian is more popular. So, it's Mr. Stričko presentation. Maybe some of you already saw it in Bratislava, where he presented it, but you're not. So he started to teach by describing board, files, lines, diagonals, how to pieces are moving. So after 3 months of teaching, it means 12 teaching hours, they should know how to pieces are moving. And then they are getting known the game, the goal of the game, win, loss, chess. Very popular game is to find whether the position is mate or stalemate and or nothing. And it's maybe you know these two figures. They are very popular in Slovakia and Czech Republic. Their names are Pat and Mat. And in Slovak language, it means mate and stalemate. So they are quite unhandy and destroy everything. And it's a very, very nice series of movies for children. It's very popular. You can find hundreds of these on YouTube. After that, they are focusing on connecting chess and mathematics. Children are learn the value of pieces and solve various mathematical tasks. It means, for example, they also got this tasks from John, and they are just testing them on children. These are typical tasks. Let's say count value of white pieces compared to black pieces. Decide who has a bigger value or less value. And I think they also use this set what John presented. Then they learn notation by putting pieces or opposite, that after execution of moves, they write notation into their notebooks. Maybe this is also the more difficult task, is to write games by notation from initial position or execute moves from initial position by also castling is taught and explained why it is important and when it's allowed or not. And the final lessons are dedicated to defense against chess. How are possibilities to defend against chess? Probably it's a mistake because when it's a mate, there is no defense. In the second year, they start with repetition, which is very important because when I was trainer, usually like one third of lesson is about repetition of already presented material. They also make some memory tests, like this is written that white or black pieces are on the demo board, and I think they have to memorize the position, and then demo board is hidden, and they have to put pieces on the right places, right squares. I have to say that Mr. Stričko, in the past he was in the military, and he's rather strict to them, and maybe it's key to his success, because as Vierka said, that there is too much women in primary school education, so he has authority, and I think in such community it's very important to have an authority as a teacher. Then they are learning double attack, and also how knight can jump from one square to another. It's typical from corner to corner. So this is also the second grade lessons, when children already know to count till 100, so they can have more sophisticated tasks to solve. They are already prepared to solve even double moves, checkmates, and write them. This is third year lessons. They already learn technique with king and pawn against king, how to win and how to save this position. If somebody make promotion of the pawn, it's win, or the other side has defense task to save a draw. This is probably the similar task as Vierka shown, that you have to put pieces on the squares to thread at least the least number of squares. It's rather tricky test. We have it in our seminar. And how many we reach? Ak najmenej sme dosiahli s tými figurkami, že...
A v tejto úlohe? 9?
So, we found that if you put pieces on the right squares, then they attack only 9 squares all together. Maybe you can try it.
Ale nebude sa nepovedať na svojich štrach
zúdiť. I spent like 15 minutes so this quest, and it's not easy. So in the third year they already can play chess his teammates, because they know the rules. They know everything about the game, and it's probably more interesting for them. The third grade is finished of this subject. This is how common a chess course is, that it's not part of curricula, but it's after school activity. In a majority, this is typical chess in school activity in Slovakia. Only few schools have it as a subject. Vierka schools, Veľká Ida, and maybe third school in Nová Dubnica, and maybe two more schools. So altogether, like 5 schools teach where chess is taught as a regular subject or as a part of the mathematics. The future, we believe, it's bright, because just this Wednesday, Anatoly Karpov, the legend, world champion, visited already four times Bratislava, and his school was opened in Bratislava. It was big event. Mr. Danko is the chairman of Slovak National Council. Also, people from Ministry of Education were present. And in the August of next year, there will be European Youth Championship in Slovakia, in Bratislava. So they promised that they will support it by 500,000 of euro. And part of this money will be also used for various chess in school activities, let's say, to equip schools with the chess board. So we believe that they fulfill their word. This was also from this Wednesday, the Christmas tournament of the chairman, Mr. Danko, with president of federation, and also Mr. Karpov was there. And I took one shot from there. It's a team tournament of four teams. One team are children, the second are students, the third are well-known persons from politics, from sport, from culture, and the fourth team is by the elder people, and this young girl is, by the way, from Roma minority. It's probably the only Roma majority member of the federation. And the game, I think, was quite long and ended in draw. She played against Mr. Maislan, the whole life chess player and trainer. So thank you for your attention.